So let's discuss what types of benchmarks do we have out there. We can have real applications. They're the most representative of real applications, but they're also the most difficult to set up on a new machine. So for example, if we're building a new computer system, we may not be able to run a full-fledged operating system there and have all the, you know, graphics cards and hard drives, etc., etc., connected. So it may not be possible to run, for example, a web browser or a database on this machine yet. Next, we can have application kernels. We find the most time-consuming part of an application, usually a loop of some sort, and we isolate just that loop and say that this is what are we going to use for testing performance of machines. That way, we don't have to run a full-blown application. All we have to do is find a way to run just the kernels on the new machine that we are testing. But sometimes, running a reasonable-sized kernel is still too difficult. For example, in the early stages of prototyping a machine, when we may not even have a compiler, for example. So the next class of benchmarks are the so-called synthetic benchmarks. They're usually designed to behave similarly to some type of a kernel, but to be much simpler to compile. Pretty much they're kind of the abstract of a kernel. And finally, we can compare machines not based on how well they perform on some actual code that they're running, but purely based on peak performance. In theory, how many instructions per second should this machine be able to execute? Usually, peak performance is only good for marketing. Doesn't tell us very much about the actual performance of the machine. Synthetic benchmarks are usually very good for design studies of potential new machines, but they're not very good for actually reporting performance to others. So we can use this just to see how well do we expect a design to behave so that we can choose among multiple possible designs. Once we actually build a machine, we can use, for example, kernels to test the performance of a prototype. And finally, we should be using real applications if we are comparing actual machines that we are trying to, for example, sell to somebody.